I'm going to present this software that I'm developing, is a work in progress for Provide project and for IMARS. It's an idea to use all open source components to have a good WebJS to manage planetary data. You know that it's not very easy to use open source server in this way, because not all can manage datum from planetary data. Okay. We decide to have this infrastructure, and it's a standard infrastructure for every WebJS. Just here, we managed to have a really not map server. This was the first version. We changed, we switched to use QGIS map server, because with QGIS map server and the latest ProJ library, it's possible to include all planetary datum and reference system to manage data. All to have standard services, because we thought that the first things is to have interoperability between data. The same schema with all components. And the structure with all components and with a few with approach to security. We have a public interface. We have a not public interface secured with a proxy. All components, so for a standard WebJS, there is nothing different for a standard WebJS. We can just see here a few 3D GIS tools to show something that is produced by other component of this project of Provide, in particular in details point clouds for and panorama. All components, nothing different, and I won't bore you with these things. This is the main capabilities and the main functions that we can have. We have a OGC server gateway to expose data, not just for our project, but also for different projects. We have a point cloud viewer, a capability to manage annotation, because we want to share knowledge. We have to co-involve all community of scientists to manage panoramas, text node, and also to show data from rover, in this case pictures. We saw before in the robot presentation on one of the first slides, we saw that it's possible to select a footprint and to see picture from rover. I had a different approach, it's not very different, because I wrote the web client to be the more general possible. In the client, there isn't a definition of a reference system, but it's loaded when you make your map. This it's a good idea to manage data from different sources and to integrate in the same context, because we can have data projected in different way, and we can reproject on fly and show on the same context. Okay. We will share this kind of knowledge through the WebGIS. We will share observation, we will share maps, point clouds, panoramas. Okay. We can see we have a standard WebGIS interface with a few tools that we made for geological mapping. There is a capability to show point cloud, ordered point cloud. In this case, I used the PO3 library. It's a library that is built on top of TreeJS that use GPU to render image, to render point cloud, or to render content in a web browser. It's a very performant library. Maybe we can see, if you have time, a little demo. We can manage panorama, also observation and text load. Okay, I'm going very fast through the interface. We have footprint. Okay, we have here the capability to manage length. If you try to use GeoServer as a server OGC compliant to expose planetary data, you have just one problem, just a big problem. It doesn't manage reference system different from APSG. You can just use reference system from the Earth, nothing different. And we have to do something, we have to make a fake code, we have to do something, but it's not possible to have the right coordinate, it's not possible to measure length. It's possible to add data from a catalog, not just for an internal catalog, but also for external resources that expose WMS or WFS services. Okay, all the standard tools for a WebGIS, you can add overlay, you can delete overlay, you can manage transparency, all the usual. It's possible to add notes as layer. It's possible to make annotation. Of course, to extract a profile, it's possible to manage point cloud, to show point cloud, point cloud, to make a few kind of annotation on point cloud, and to manage panorama. This panorama, of course, are panorama produced from NavCam and PanCam, from other component of this project provider. Okay, this is just the administration site to manage map, to create a new map, to store annotation. Here you can see this is a map, this is a definition of the map, because when you have a session in this new software, you can save your session, you can retrieve your map in the same way you left. We can add a layer, we can add, this is very interesting for me, because I have one main thing, interoperability. Just to add resources for interoperability, you can retrieve this information, you can load data in your map. This is the definition annotation. The annotation are just GeoJSON, stored in GeoJSON format. In this way you can download, you can use in your desktop GIS software. Okay, this is very short presentation.